don't go like this. You see that? How you spiral in, don't spiral in. If you spiral in, what stops him from punching your face rather than stop blocking your hand? So take a look at this. If I go like this, yes, why would he block my hand when his hand is also close to my face? Assume that he's also trained. Yes, so that's why you maintain the distance. Right. So when I punch him, basically, if I punch him here, yes, the reaction will be same like this. Right. So if I hit him, that should be how far he's, because I'm not hitting him full blast, I'm hitting to control the distance. So if I touch his shoulder, see that is the same power if I want to hit him in the face, because I cannot generate power in this movement. Make sense or not? So I'm using that as a distraction. Right. So if I can get that, the next movement is boom. See, I got this foot, up, he goes down. Now I break his ankle as he falls. Yes? If not, I break it. But now I want to do a simple technique, so something you can follow, yes? So one, two, three. Inside, I pass. Now I jab. Once I'm here, I cut. Inside, inside. Or one, two, three. I'm here, yes? Here. Yes? I jab. I continue, look at my leg. Dislocate the shoulder. Yes? So again. Go back. So, one, two, three. Insert. I jab here. See, I'm aligned to kick. So I'm trying to kick his face, but the elbow is in the way. So when I kick the elbow up, it should dislocate the shoulder. There. Right, guys? Make sense? Isn't it? So, for any purposes, same intention. One, two, three. Punch the face. Yes, see that? This. So as I come in, that's it. I aligned it correctly. Boom. But for training purposes, this, sorry, there. Then it's a takedown. Yes? You can finish up here. One, two, three. Insert there. Hit again before you do this. Then once you're there, align, step up. So you can break, cut. Turn. So again, yes? I hit. That. Here. Inside. Yes? Here. Inside. I pass. Take a look at this, yes? I hit him first. I'm using my hand to slide. If somehow, as I hit him, he pulls back this way, pull back, I lose it, yes? So pull back. See, I have that. So that's why I'm sliding here. So when he slides, he pulls back, at least I have that trap, and I continue the flow. But because it's seminar, he lets that hand hang there for just a few seconds, enough for me to do a follow-up for the seminar. Move back. So he comes into the face. Boom. It's up, boom, boom. Then once I'm here, this one, hold the meat of the thumb. There. So once you're there, use your hand, slide it out for the face. Yes? Now once you're there, pull it back. So you have this. Once you have this, what you need to do is the middle finger, yes, fold it to the center of his forearm. And now go 45 degrees there. Now slide. See how you open him up? So you're not doing this. You're doing this. You slide it. Because if I go straight like this, he might step forward and grab me. And that's it. There's a counter for that. So to make sure that he doesn't step forward, drop his knee first. There. Now you slide it. So now, his elbow is just below your hips. Like, yes? So when you do this, you're supposed to dislocate the shoulder, like that. Yes? So what my intention is, I don't want to hit to break the shoulder, I want to hit his face. But because the elbow is in between, I go through his shoulder. So down here, boom. So he goes up, cut. This one, in reality, take the pin. Is that okay now? I know it's a bit complicated, but you finish off on the kick to the elbow. The rest is just I'm showing you options. So just the options, yes? Okay. Yes, sorry. So options, yes? Here. One, two, three. Insert. I'm there. Here. Insert. I break. I cut. Then I'm here. See that? See that? Break the footings. So I'm there. One, you break, cut it. If you cut it, you might disarm the blade. But if it doesn't, then one move, and you're there. Right? But just stop on the breaking of the shoulder. So I'm there. So, one, two, three. Inside, pass, there. Grab, here, that's it. Okay? Yes?